And getting straight into the top five news stories of the day. The battle over whether or not to build the Keystone pipeline from Canada to the Gulf of Mexico has long been stalled in both houses of Congress. But the new initiative got new life yesterday. Reports say the main reason is Democrats are trying hard to help Senator Mary Landrieu keep her seat in Louisiana. Supporters of the pipeline say it will create tens of thousands of jobs, while those opposed say it will have a horrible impact on the environment. And some scary news from overseas. Three U.S. sailors were assaulted in Turkey while they were taking some time off their ship. Officials say the attackers belong to a group called the Turkish Youth Union. At one point, you can see some guys try and place bags over the sailors' heads. And later, the group published comments saying the bags were in protest to American imperialism in the Middle East. Fortunately, the sailors were able to run away and make it back to their ship. The Turkish Ministry of Foreign Affairs has condemned the attack. The incident is being investigated. And for those of you who love the sexy science of space, then you know that yesterday history was made. Cheers all around for the European Space Agency as the Rosetta spacecraft successfully deployed a lander onto a speeding comet. This is a first for any of the countries in the space exploration business and is designed to give us a lot of answers about the universe. The Rosetta was launched in 2004. This has been a long time coming. And if you've been enjoying the lower gas prices recently, I know I have, get ready to be happy a little bit longer. The U.S. Energy Department predicted that the average price for a gallon of gas in 2015 will be around $2.94. If this new lower estimate holds true, then consumers in this country will save about $61 billion next year. Cheers to cheap gas. And last in your top five news, looks like the desire for marijuana in Colorado may be burning out. Reports indicate the initial surge we saw back in January with hour-long lines outside of pot shops may be dying out. Sales in September fell for the first time since January, but experts say not to worry. The drop is likely due to a lull in tourism during these months of the year. They still estimate sales between 300 and 400 million this year. You can buy a lot of weed with that money, that's for
sure. That's a lot of weed.
That is a lot
of weed. That is a very true.